literature is very ambitious because I will speak about the WHO concept of healthy aging. I have to tell you a few words concerning this concept. It was prepared by the group which is called Aging and Life Course Process of WHO. And we started working, and I started working with this group in 2012. And the conference was ready in 2015. It was presented to more than 70 different experts from all around the world. But in fact, I was 2016 because the World Assembly voted this definition and voted this new definition of healthy aging on May 16, 2016. So it was very recent, and the vote was done by 155 different ministries of health from different countries. So it is really something which is very important, but not yet well known. So we have also the problem of disparity between different countries, and within the same countries, life expectancy is not the same if you are in the richest part or in the poorest part of the country. And if you are looking at Washington DC, living downtown Washington DC, or living in the submarine, it's completely different. And the difference in life expectancy is two parts of the same town, can say, is 70 years. And if you are going just west in Glasgow, between living in the richest part of Glasgow or in the suburb part of Glasgow, the life expectancy at birth is 28 years. And the main question is, what are these additional factors? And they are called health or health aging determinants. And what is crucial to well understand today is that in fact only 25% of our genes have a fixed expression all over your life. These genes are linked to progeria, as I showed you before, or to specific diseases. But in fact, only 25% of that are fixed. 75% of our genetic background are in fact can be modified or would be modified during our life. And it is linked to the country characteristics, we could say continental characteristics. Could be linked to culture and religion. Could be linked to social, political choices, could be linked to the environmental context. That we have not to forget that within this health determinant, we, each of us, has also a claim to have. What is dignified health? How each of us can imagine our dignified health? Probably, it is based on the preliminary agreement on end-of-life objectives, but also on therapeutic intensity. And I spoke about the attitude of the American going to ICU before dying. It is something that we have to think of, and which is also something that tradition has helped us. Can be improved at any age. And I will show you randomized controlled trials proving you that we can do something. So, indeed, and it is the start of my talk, when you are speaking about aging, we are speaking about life course project. And as the addition, I will mainly focus on the second part of life. And I will mainly focus on midlife prevention of age-related disability. Is it to increase the function at an old age? So, when you are thinking about
the prevention of inhabilities of the board population. We have two main components. The first one is called frailty. And I saw your face 2 minutes ago when I spoke for the first time about frailty, but I will tell you exactly what is frailty. And we are also saying about frailty. We know now very well the risk factors of frailty and the risk factors of chronic diseases. And we know that we have two kinds of possible action: health promotion and intervention. It is the prevention of cardiorenal vascular disease prevention. And it is really a fantastic study with Mediterranean diet. They included around 7,500 volunteers in the age of 55 to 80 with high cardiovascular risk. And they had three kinds of intervention: Mediterranean diet plus olive oil, 10 millimeter per day. Mediterranean diet plus mixed 30 grams per day, and controlled diet to decrease the fat into the diet. And what they showed, after only 5 years, only 5 years, they stopped the study because it was very positive. They showed that they can decrease the cardiovascular, neurovascular event by about 30%. Can you imagine that? So continue taking olive oils and nuts, which is very good, plus some intramyte. 30% of the cardiovascular disease. When you are looking at the fact that they are increasing the risk of dementia by 40 to 50%, 60%, 80% double the risk. Indeed, you can say, we can do something. And we can do something by prevention of the cardio, neuro, and renovascular risk factors. Because all of them are cardio, neurovascular risk factors in life. And if you have the malchance to be at the same time, midlife, hypercholesterolemia, with diabetes, and you have at the same time hypertension, midlife, your risk of being demented when you will be 80 will be multiplied by 6. So please treat for midlife, and it is exactly the message that was given by WHO at the beginning. All the persons are doing their best in their ways, and very often the patient is in the middle without knowing who is right, who he has to follow, who is the correct person to. So I think that if the language is common, if the problem are shared, if the solution is found in group, it is better for the patient and for the family. And we have to know that when we are speaking about the patient, it is, we are very close this is the question before. The geriatrician and the pediatrician are very close. Pediatricians are taking care of the children with the parents. We are taking care of the parents with the children. And we have to know that it is this kind of groups that we have to manage together and to have. And the way of doing this kind of sharing the problem, trying to find a solution together is very important. And what is also very important, and it is also one of my tasks actually, is to try to change the mind of the organ specialists. They are speaking about organ, organ, organ. They are no more thinking about the body. They are no more thinking about the surroundings. And what which one of my tasks actually is to try to build interdisciplinary teaching activities between different kinds of specialists, because we need to speak together to have the same kind of problem. If not, it will be a disease. And for the last, it will be the same, and it will start very soon. Also, the comments. And if all of them are under control, you will have a very healthy age. And with that, I just